I once again welcome you all of you to the lecture series of microprocessor and microcontrollers. Today is day 12 and it is 5th May 2021. So today we are going to discuss the general bus operation of 8086 microprocessor. General bus operation of 8086 microprocessor. You see this before going to that one. Once again, we are able to see this basic structure of the microprocessor. This is CPU, ALU. It has registers and timing and control unit. It has memory, RAM and ROM memory equally divided. 1 MB, 1 MB RAM and ROM memory. This 1 MB MB is equally divided. Another 0.5 MB is RAM, 0.5 MB is ROM. So then I/O devices, input output devices. That memory size is maximum memory size is able to tank to this CPU is only of 64 KB only. Because the address lines we are used here, A0 to the A15. Here that 16 lines, so 2 power 16 is equal to the 64 KB. But here the address lines we are used here, the A0 to the A15, A16 to the A19. So total of 20 address lines, so 2 power 20 is equal to the 1 MB. So this way we are able to calculate the memory size as well as input output device size. So the maximum memory we are able to connect to this 8086 CPU is 1 MB only. So the maximum input output devices memory we are able to connect the CPU is 64 KB memory only. Beyond that, it is unable to connect the microprocessor. In other words, microprocessor is not able to read the memory as well as input output device when the size is exceeded that one. Okay, so now see this A0 to the 15, but actually these lines are available in AD0 to the A15. AD15, you know that very well. Here this one also same. AD0 to the it is available in the real format is 15. But you want to on this some address latch enable, address lines is convert into the some data lines and all. So microprocessors perform two operations like read and just read and write, but it cannot erase the information and all. It can only overwrite the information. That memory is overwritten at the same time. Input output device information is also overwritten at the same time. Registers information available in the registers also, we are just overwrite only. We are not erase the data. You just overwrite. And but if the previous data is available, you send the data. That is the data is erased and store the new data. Okay, it is just overwrite the data only. So okay, microprocessor is unable to erase the any of the data. Microprocessor is perform two operations like read operations and write operations. A read means here a copy operation. A write means here a send. Remember, read means here copy operation. Write means here send operation. Nothing copy means whenever the information at the memory, when that information is needed by the CPU, that on that time it performs the read operation. Whenever there is information in the CPU, you want to send that information to the memory, and that time microprocessors perform the write operations. But all the information, whatever it may be, you send the information or you receive the information or you can address the memory locations, okay, by this memory and all, that will be done by using this bus, or you can also call it as a general bus. We have different types of buses are there. Data buses, okay, address buses, okay, control buses, okay. So now we can take the general bus. That means it has both address as well as data buses. Now you see this how this general bus operation is performed. How this general bus is helpful to identify the memory locations memory location nothing but the address locations in this memory. Okay, now who can control this CPU at the same time memory as well as timing and control unit? This input output devices. Yes, this timing and control unit, it controls the CPU at the same time memory, at the same time input and output devices. How it will be controlled? By sending the a fixed number of clocks. A clocks are like this, a fixed number of clocks. This is one, we can also call it as T1 time period, T2 time period, T3 time period, and so on. It can send it just like this clocks to control the CPU at the same time memory as well as the input output devices. Now we are going to discuss our main discussion is today nothing but general bus operation is mainly depends on this this control unit, timing and control unit. Okay, now see this small discussion here. You know that what is the main functionality of this the general bus operation and all, what is the use of this general bus and all, why you are considered this general bus operation and all means here. You know that our microprocessor is only a 40 pins. DAP means dual in package, only a 40 pins. So out of that 40 pins, so you know that microprocessor is operating in two different modes, macro mode and min mode. Okay, so 32 pins are common for both maximum and minimum mode. Only 8 pins are different for maximum and minimum. But here the question is, the main question is, so how effectively you can utilize that 40 pins to improve the performance of the microprocessor? Because you have only 32 pins here. Out of that 32 pins, for suppose you can allocate 20 pins per addresses, remaining 20 pins only are available. Then whatever the data lines and whatever the address lines, then whatever the power supply, then whatever the clocks and whatever the traps and the interrupts and what. So for better utilization of the pins, we are using same pins for multiple purposes. Yes, we are considering AD0 to AD15 means here the same lines used for both address as well as used for both data lines. So that type of lines you can call it as a multiplex lines. Remember multiplexer. Okay, then there is some unidirectional lines also there. What is unidirectional? A address lines are address lines and some lines are unidirectional. Only can send the information in one way. Okay, you have a bidirectional lines also there. What bidirectional means here? The same lines it can send the information at the same time. The same lines it receive the information. So both way transmission. It can transmit the information. It can receive the information. That is the best example for that one is AD, nothing but data lines G0 to the D15 lines. Data lines are bidirectional lines. The same lines we are using for send the information, at the same time the same lines we are using for receive the information. But address is the unidirectional, only one way direction. Okay, how this happened? Nothing but how here we are discussing that the same lines, these lines are used for address at the same time used for data. The same lines. Okay, how you know that these lines AD0 to 15, A18 to 19 lines always available at the address? Always available at the address. So once it is available in the address mode, then you can activate it. There's some pins like ALE address cache enable, so it can convert that address lines to the data lines. It can convert the address lines to the data lines. but the conversion, we have some different types of tri-state buffers, transceivers, some different types of devices are used to convert this address lines to the data lines. Okay, so how it will be converted in reality? So how many clock cycles are needed to receive the information or send the information to the memory and all? Okay, that we will call it as timing diagrams. Then we can see it in timing diagram way. Nothing but see this. For suppose I want the information from the memory. See this. For example, this is the memory locations. This is address. This is the data. This is the address. Address 1000001. For suppose this is the address. So in this address location, my data is available. That data you can assume it as a 07H, the hexadecimal format 07H. I want this information to transmit from memory to the CPU. I can perform this type of operation, read operation. Okay, so microprocessors perform read operation. So this timing and control unit is send the fixed number of clocks to activate this operation, to perform this operation, read operation. A timing and control unit, it can send some fixed number of clocks. So how this operation is performed by the microprocessor, and we will see it in some diagrammatically before going to that one. So for simplicity purpose, you see this data is available in this address location 1001. So my data is 07. Okay, so how the data is identified? First of all, microprocessor is send some address locations, so through this address lines. So this address lines is identifies the, so the data is at this address location. Okay, first of all, that is done. Okay, address lines. But you know that, so the same lines we are using for address and data lines. Now that address lines will be converted into the data lines. How it will be happen? So how many clock cycles, then timing and control unit, how it will be behave to transmit the data from memory to the CPU, how that address lines are converted to the data lines, how much time is required to convert that address lines to the data lines. Okay, how the data is read, then once it is read, how the data is available in the bus, data bus, and nothing but the general bus, data bus. So first of all, it will be in address bus mode. Once you can on the ALE, it will convert into the data. How much time is required to convert that address to the data? Okay, that all the information will, that all the things we will see it in some timing diagrams. You can call it as a, that some diagrams, the diagrams you can call it as a timing diagrams. So we have different types of timing diagrams are there. For each and every operation, we have one separate timing diagrams are there. So for our simplicity purpose, today class we are going to discuss the only read and write operations. Read timing diagrams as well as the write timing diagrams of memory for our simplicity purpose. Okay. Now see this. Now look at this. Memory read cycle as well as the memory write cycle. Or we can divide it into the separately, because microprocessors perform these two operations separately. First of all, so it cannot perform these two operations at a time. Once it perform read operation, or it can perform write operation, whatever it may be. This may be of available here memory write cycle or here memory read cycle, whatever it may be. You cannot confuse that one. For the examination, they can ask that general bus operation of 8086 microprocessor. You draw the this entire timing diagrams. You can call this as the timing diagrams. Okay, then we will going to explain them. So in sometimes they can ask that you draw the memory read cycle. You can only just draw up to this one only, up to this one. Sometimes they can ask that the memory write cycle. So you can draw the just this one. So we can add these names to this ends and we can draw this one. Okay. So okay, very easy. Okay. So this this for our simplicity purpose, microprocessors perform only one operation at a time. Whether that may be a read operation or write operation. So we can divide this entire general purpose operation to the two cycles, read cycle as well as write cycle, and we can combine that two. Then after we can combine that two. First of all, you can see this memory read cycle. Memory read cycle. Yes, see this. So I cut this one. See this. I cut this this part part for our simplicity purpose here. So I can present it here. You can see this. Okay. You can see this. Okay. So this is a clock. You know that this is the clock. What is this clock? A clock is nothing but the a quartz crystal oscillator. Who can supply this clock to the timing and control unit? So a quartz crystal oscillator is supply the quartz crystal oscillator. Okay, is supply the clock continuously clocks to this timing and control unit. Continuously, it can supply the clocks to the continuously a crystal oscillator, but this timing and control unit separated these clocks to the different operations. Please wait. Now see this. How this happened? How this happened? So how this control unit controls the clocks to separated by the unsend the a fixed number of clocks to perform the read and write operations. See this. So read cycle. Read means it. So the information is available at the memory. That information is wanted by the CPU. So on that way, microprocessor is perform the read operations. Okay, read means here copy. So memory to the remember memory to the okay CPU. Read operation means here CPU to the can see the arrows. CPU to the CPU of nothing but memory to the CPU. See this arrow. See this arrow. Information from memory to the CPU. Read operation. RD bar. Read RD bar. Remember RD bar. Bar means a negative logic. Remember negative logic. So it can conduct at this stage and negative stage. Negative logic, okay, and negative logic. So how that negative logic is available? Okay, so whatever it may be, the clocks, the negative clock. So clocks we are also separated by the two ways: a positive clock as well as a negative clock, and double clock is also available. But here, 8086 microprocessors use the a negative clock, a negative edge triggered clock. Right, it is a negative edge triggered clock. Edge triggered means it can trigger the nothing, it can on the clocks in this direction. Okay, T1, T2, and this way. Okay, now our intention is remember careful. This is very easy. You cannot confuse that one. Very simple. Our aim is to transfer whatever the information present in the memory to the CPU. So that purpose microprocessor is perform the operation called the read cycle, read operation. How that read operation is performed by this microprocessor? A very simple things. Very simple things. So you know that so memory is address is available at the some location 1001 location for suppose. In this address location, the data 07 is available. Same example you can test 1001. So this is the address. So address is identified by the address lines. A, AD, nothing but A0 to the A15, and we have the address lines A0, A16 to the A19. But these lines are available at the you have the AD, really these lines are AD0 to the AD15. But always these lines are in general, these lines are available in the address mode. Whenever you want that one, it will be converted into the address to the data. Okay. So what is this address lines? So microprocessor is identified, microprocessor is send some address locations to this address lines to the memory. So based on that address locations, microprocessor nothing but is identify this address location through where you can send that address location through that address bus. Through that address bus is nothing but to that address lines you send the information. Okay, so the data is available at the 100. Okay, so the address bus identify the identify the address locations 1001. So 1001, now it has the data. So the functionality of that address bus is over. Now what our intention is that, so the data is coming back to the CPU. How the data is back to the CPU. That purpose, that address lines is convert into the data links. So that purpose, address lines is convert into the data links. Okay. Once it is data is converted, so that the data through the data lines you send the information. That all the thing. So to perform the all the things, microprocessor is required the 4 clock cycles. 4 clock periods, remember T1, T2, T3. I will tell you what is TW, then T4. Remember, 4 clock cycles are represented. 4 timing cycles, 4 clock cycles are required. So for the same read, it requires 4 operations, 4 clock cycles at the same time. Write also, it requires 4 clock cycles. Right. Yes. For this read operations, it requires 4 clock cycles. At the same time, write operation also, it requires 4 clock cycles. So microprocessor is want the data from the memory, it requires 4 clock cycles. So that purpose, microprocessor is perform the read operations. Now, how to initiate that read operation by the CPU to get the information from the memory? Yeah, very simple. So first of all, CPU, so you tell that microprocessor the data is available at some locations for 1001 locations. So microprocessor is handed that location and given that information to the bus interface unit. You know that last class we are also seen in the architecture. So it has architecture as 2 units, execution unit as well as the bus interface unit. Okay, so in bus interface unit is nothing but bus interface unit is responsible for identifying the address locations or input output locations, input output memory locations as well as primary memory locations to transfer the data, at the same time to receive the data. Okay, so now see, microprocessor is identify that address locations and send that information through that bus. That bus is identify this address location that has the data. So that purpose, microprocessor is perform the read cycle operations, 4 read cycle operations. Okay, you clarity on that one. Okay, now see this. When the data is performed by these operations, so microprocessor is enabled all the pins to on. So microprocessor perform read operation or write operation. So that purpose, it wants this number of pins to on and off to perform this operation, read operation. So microprocessor for read operation, timing and control unit, you know that. So for every operation, timing and control unit, it can send the fixed number of clock cycles. Okay, so for this operation, timing and control unit can generate the 4 clock cycles. So out of that 4 clock cycles, so remember, out of that 4 clock cycles only, CPU is identify the memory locations, and at the same time, that memory location we have the data is also transferred from memory to the CPU. So this 4 clock cycles only. So remember, the clock cycles means here hedges. We have the 5 mega hedges clock, you know that 8 mega hedges clock, then 10 mega hedges clocks are available. So if the speed of the clock is increases, the speed of the microprocessor is also increases. You now this is the best example for speeding the speed. Nowadays we have the microprocessors available at 3.2 gigahertz, the clock speeds. But you know that you can see this how fast they are working. Okay, now see this this microprocessor is only 3 clock cycles are available: 5 megahertz, 8 megahertz, 10 megahertz. The clock speed is increases. The speed of the speed of operations of the microprocessor is also increases. So the microprocessor entire performance is also changes. Okay, so for this 4 clock cycles, the entire 4 clock cycles only, microprocessor is identify the address locations, memory address locations at the same time. So that address location has some data. The data is also transferred from memory to the CPU. Only these 4 clock cycles. How it will happen? So these 4 clock cycles is microprocessor is divided into the some separate divisions and separate operations. So to perform the entire thing, okay. So under T1 clock cycle, remember the T1 clock period, T1 period time period. Remember simply T1 time period. Remember T1 time period. Microprocessor is identify the memory locations of the address locations in that memory. Remember. T1 clock cycle, T1 period, identify the address location of the memory. Remember, you can note down this one. At T1 clock period, microprocessor is nothing but a CPU is identify the address locations in that memory. Once it is identified, so microprocessors know, okay, so the data is at address location, nothing but it is identified that address location. Microprocessors identify the data in that address location at the T1 clock period. Then we have remaining 4 clock period also available. Remaining 3. So you just forget this one. I will tell you why this is TDM, why this is. So So whenever anyone asks that how many clock periods are required to perform the read cycle, you must tell that it is only 4 clock cycles. I tell you why TW. Okay, first of all, you just forget that one, TW. Okay, so under T1 clock period, okay, microprocessors identify the data address locations. Okay, address locations. Then this T2 clock period. So you know that microprocessor is used the multiplexer lines for address as well as the data. The same lines you can use it for address as well as the same line you can use it as a data lines. So in under T2 clock period, the address lines is converting to the data lines. T2 here address to the data lines. Address to the data lines, remember. At T1 clock period, my CPU is identify the data location, address locations that are present in the data, in the memory. At T2 clock period, address lines is converted into the data lines. It requires one time period. But how it will be converted address to the data, it will not be directly converted. That purpose an AL is required, address latch enable. So see this, an address is enabled. Now see this, The upward direction means here, you see this AL, it has no borrow. It has no borrow, nothing but, so there is no borrow. In the timing and diagrams, it represents, in the micropositive, it represents a high, nothing but this way. This way. It is zero after that this is zero. This is one, remember, this is one, this is zero. This is enable or disable or on or off or on off, remember, on or off, because there is no bar on that one. There is a bar on ALE bar, but it can work as a zero, it can off as a one. So but there is no bar on that one. If ALE is enabled T1 clock period, remember, why this is enabled at the T1 period and why it is disabled at the T2 period. This address latch enabled because at T1 clock period, so T1 clock period, the lines are in address mode only. After T2 period only, remember, after T2 period onward only, the address lines are converted into the data. So that will be converted by, so microprocessors want one clock period to convert address lines to the data lines. So now microprocessor is directly, it will not be directly converted this address to the data. So that's why microprocessor is on the address latch enabled. Okay. Yes. Okay. This is enabled. Okay. So after this, so address lines are after T2, T3, TW onwards, this address lines are converted into the data. What is the use of this S2 bar and S1? Remember, S2 bar and S2, nothing but a zero is on, one is off, because that is a negative latch. This is a negative latch. So these lines, S2 bar and S2 bar, nothing but, you know that A19 to A16, you know that. These lines are also, you know that. A16 slash S6 or S3 or A19 slash S6 and so on. You know that some status lines are also the status lines also. So the status lines also convert, these address lines also convert into the status by seeing this S0 and S2. So microprocessor, you want to know that microprocessor is perform this type of operation, either read operation or write. Okay, at the same time. So this is the representation of address and status lines. This is the representation of address and status lines, A19 to the A16, and T1 clock period, you know that at T1 clock period, these are worked as address lines. After enabling this T2 clock period onwards, this address lines is also converted into the status lines. This will be represented by, you know that AD0 to the AD15. Once ALE is on, this A16 to the S3, A19 to the S7 is also converted into the status lines. Now that here, this is our important. This address is converted into the data. Now see this at T1 clock period. See this at T1 clock period. This is an address mode. After T2 onwards, so this is a data bus. This is a data bus. Data bus. Now onwards, this is a T2 clock period onwards up to the T4 data bus. So now microprocessor is perform the read operation at which clock period? T1 clock period, T2, T3, TW, or T4. On which clock period? So microprocessor is perform read operation at T2 clock period onwards only. T2 clock period onwards only. It will not be perform the T1 clock period, because so at T1 clock period, microprocessor, the state of that lines are in address lines. Okay, that's why microprocessor is perform the some operations Okay, see this. Okay, read operations. Okay. See this. Yes, we can just arrange the one. Read operations. Read. When it will be performed, the read. Okay. Just cancel this one. No, that is the next one. Okay, see this. So microprocessors for when that microprocessors perform the read operation at T2 clock period onwards, at T2 clock period. T1 clock period, microprocessor the address lines. So microprocessor the general bus is in address mode. Then the next T2 clock period is required to convert the address to the data. So read operation is performed the after the T2 clock period onwards. Okay. Okay, I will erase all the things. Okay, so what is the functionality of this TW? What is TW? Why means here we are coming to this TW. And ready and TW, there is interlink between the TW means here wait time period. TW means here wait time period or inactive time period. In some cases you can also call it as inactive time period. So most of the cases you can call it as a wait time period. Wait. Why means a wait? What is the use of this ready? You know that CPU is connected to the memory. You know that very well. There is a speed mismatch between the CPU as well as the memory devices. So for that purpose, you want to reduce the speed of the microprocessor is the one way to match the speed of the memory. But that is not a good decision to reduce the speed of the microprocessor. Once you reduce the speed of the microprocessor, that impact will be on the entire that will be. That impact will be placed on the entire performance of the microprocessor. So that's why to match the speed of the microprocessor as well as the nothing but CPU as well as the memory device, then extra reads and extra time period is generated by the timing and control unit. So the time to read that information is increased. So you are not reduces the speed, the clock speed, remember. So our two ways are possible. What is one way is to so you can match the speed because CPU speed is always more when compared to the memory. So what is so to reduce the speed of the microprocessor to match the memory, so this is not the better solution. So that's why what they did is here. So out of this four clock periods, they can add the another clock period to match the speed of the CPU as well as the memory. For that purpose, CPU is generated the ready signal, ready and ready signal. So now see this state up to this third state. You see this third state up to this third state as a T3 clock period up to this T3 clock period. This pin is under wait state, nothing but wait state, under disabled state, wait state. After that, it is ready. Ready means here, microprocessor is ready. Ready means here, what is the meaning of ready? So the speed is matched. Speed is matched until that one. So microprocessor is generated the wait ready signal. That means microprocessor is wait to gather the information from the memory. Because it will match as this. Once the speed is matched, that one, so it can generate the ready signal. So on that time, microprocessor is ready to read the information from the memory. But it is so it is not at all over now at the same time. Microprocessor is also, you know that the same data lines is used to send the information, that the same data lines is used to receive the information. So that's why use the data transmission and the data receive. So which operation you perform here? Read operation means a memory to the CPU. So nothing but the receive operation you can perform. So that's why R bar is equal to the zero. You can perform that. So you can see this zero, negative logic. See this zero, a zero. It can operate at the zero, zero. Now the data lines are ready to take the information, ready to take the information from the memory to the CPU. But it is not at all carry the information. Remember all these operations. Then data enable. Now microprocessor is perform this operation also. Data enable. Now here see this RD bar. So this RD bar, is on at the after the T2 clock grid to the and so on up to the T2, T4 clock. Once this is performed, remember, once this is performed, whatever the data is available in that one is now that is moving to the CPU. Once again, I will explain in clarity. So first of all, see this CPU memory. Once again, see this the data 100000. The data 07. Okay, see this. So the address here in this one, the address is 1001. Yes. Okay. Nothing but 1001. Okay. This will be performed by this. Now these lines are converted into the data lines. Okay. Now these lines are converted into the data lines. These are identify the address. First even clock grid is identify the address. After this lines are converted, this data address lines to the data lines. T1 clock grid. After the T1 number, T2 clock grid. You can see this very very simple one. See this. So our data is at 07. So it can perform the ready operation. You know that what is the meaning of ready? So to match the speed of a CPU as well as memory. So data transmit and receive. What is the use of this one? So the same data lines and data lines are used for both transmission as well as receive. So nothing but this is the zero data enable. So you can it can erase that one. It will not be there. So see this. So after the microprocessor is performed, this RD bar is equal to the zero. So once it will be performed, the data, whatever the data is available at 07 is available in the data bus to the CPU. Nothing but now see this. We will draw the diagram in this way. Once this will be performed, so whatever the data that is available in that memory locations that are available data line 07. The data is available at the data line 07. Okay, this is the way it can perform the memory read operations. Now, next one, second one, very easy one. Now go for this one. So you will see this this part. Now see this part. Now see this part only. This part only. See this. Okay. Again, you forgot this one for this operations. So for you can remember this one. So this clock and ALU, you can see this. And once again, you can see this write operation, nothing but CPU to the memory here. That also same operations. Microprocessor send the memory locations. So an empty memory locations. For that memory locations, CPU is send the information to this memory. Let's say I will send the 06H from the CPU to the memory. The address location is 0100 for suppose. So for this T1 clock period, so these lines are address lines is nothing but 10100. Okay, right side. Or can I also see the clock? CLK clock. This is ALE. This is status, S2 bar to the S0 bar. This is address as well as status lines. This is address as well as data lines. So no use of this one. So you can cancel this one because okay, then ready signal. Okay, this one is DT by R bar. Now this is DEN data enable. This is write address. Now see this. So at T1, this is address latch enable. Now see this. T1, the data is for suppose 10100. So at T2 clock base required to the address to the data. Again, so on that one, AL is enabled. Same write cycle, same operation. Likewise, the read cycle, write address matches. But on that one, you can perform the read. Here, you can write the. You can see the write address. Same. So after this one, at the same time, this address lines is also converted to the status lines. Now see this after T2 clock period. So the data. Address lines is converted into the data lines D0 to the D15 lines. Same. So again, this read ready and ready signal is generated to match the speed of the CPU as well as. Now here, which one? Data receiver transmit. You can transmit the data. Nothing but D is equal to the 1. So nothing but that is logic I. Remember, see this. This is logic I. Nothing but 1. This is logic I. This is 0. Remember, this is logic I. This is 0. Data I know. Now see this, a data write cycle is happened. Now see, you can draw the arrows here. You can draw the arrows in this. So in the examination also, you can draw the arrows on this direction. On the once it can perform the write operation, whatever the information is available at the CPU, that is transmitted to the memory. Same. So it is quite equal to the operation of the read cycle. It can also generate the 4 clock cycles and wait cycle. That what is the wait cycle? Wait cycle. You know that wait time period. Why? You match the speed of the microprocessor as well as the. Here on that way, on that we can perform the write operation. For you can send the information from the CPU to the memory. For the read operation means here from memory to the CPU. Okay, so the difference here, only you can change the difference here, DT by R bar as well as WR bar. DT by R bar means a data transmit and receive, nothing but that is equal to the 1 in write cycle, that is equal to the 0, okay, that is equal to the 0 in read cycle. Okay, both are same. Now see this, very simple. Now see this. General was operation cycle. So microprocessor is performed so separately. So read and write. But here in this diagram they can mix up and give it to you. Okay. Cannot confuse. So both are same series. So here you can perform the read operation. It can perform the write operation. So here this is the separate diagram. Okay. Thank you for joining today's class. Thank you.